I'll get the reaction of Dr. Esperanza Cabral, former Health Secretary. Dr. Cabral, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ron.
Thanks for taking our call. Now, we have an expert panel, vaccine expert panel, saying that the CoronaVac is okay for senior citizens. Do you concur with that recommendation?
Yes, well, I concur with the vaccine expert panel. They are much more expert in this particular topic than I am. And they have seen the data from Sinovac that has not yet been presented officially, but they have been shown the data. Plus, they're saying that in other countries, the vaccine is already being used among the elderly. And even here in our country, many physicians signed waivers to get Sinovac on the first day of the vaccine rollout because they believe that getting the vaccine is better than getting sick with COVID-19.
Right. Now, the FDA may revise their stand on the use of CoronaVac for senior citizens, but they would still rather wait for a convincing study, official data, to come out on the vaccine's effects on the elderly. But isn't that more prudent?
Yes. FDA is being very prudent about this. They have permitted the use of Sinovac in those more than 59 years old as long as they sign a waiver. Mm-hmm. And if the FDA remains unconvinced that it should be given in general to senior citizens, then that is the ruling that we must respect.
Okay, so we'll wait for their study, gathering of more data. We do want to ask your reaction and your thoughts to another issue. We have the testing chief, Vince Dison.
Yes.
Saying he's against indiscriminate mass testing and would rather continue with targeted testing. Do you agree with this move?
Yes, I think that if we have limited resources, we have to target the tests that we do so that we do not waste our money. But he needs to do more tests just the same. The number of targeted tests that he's doing at present is not sufficient for us to be able to catch everybody who needs to be caught that have the COVID virus or are infected.
So there is a need, of course, for more testing.
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. He may not call it mass testing, and I will agree not to call it mass testing, but he still needs to do more of them.
One final thing, Doctora. A couple of weeks back, you said that the country was 10 steps back from square one. That was before we've hit record numbers in daily cases. That was before we were put, or the NCR plus surrounding areas were put under a two-week ECQ, and our hospitals are now filled. What do you think of the situation now?
Well, I wish I were not that prophetic, but that's where we are, and we really need to deal with it and get ourselves out of this hole.
And what could be your recommendation? You just mentioned that we need more testing. Last week or this week, we're talking about tracing also. Our tracing system is not enough. We were able to talk to the tracing chief himself, who mentioned that it was deteriorating. What else is the government missing here?
Well, absolutely. The contact tracing is the weakest link in our ability to catch patients with COVID and those that they have exposed. And that is really something that the tracings are must address, as well as the rest of the IATF and the National Task Force. We cannot leave it to chance. All of these people are running around spreading the virus, and that's why it is difficult for us to reduce the number of daily cases that we have. Mm-hmm. So the contact tracing ability of the country must really be improved. But on another aspect, because these are all prevention of transmission, they have to look very, very closely at the hospital capability, our ability to treat patients who already have moderate, severe, or critical COVID, because space is running out, health workers are getting sick and also not working as much as they should be. Medicines are also running out. There is price gouging occurring everywhere. These are things that government must control. It is their duty to do this.
But Dr. Cabral, we had Malacanang saying that it may be inevitable by next week we will shift to a looser lockdown, an MECQ. Your thoughts on that?
Well, we cannot remain on extreme lockdown forever, and we cannot keep, you know, going from extreme lockdown to milder lockdown. We need to do something so that we do not need to lock down people.
Former Health Secretary Dr. Esperanza Cabral, thank you very much for talking to us.
Thank you very much, Ron. Good afternoon.